Hello friends. Let's continue exploring current models of budget mini PCs for use as a smart home server. Not so long ago, I talked about the Soyo M2 with an Intel seller in N3350. For those who haven't seen it, the link is in the description. Its main drawback was the non-working setting responsible for automatic power on. The hero of this review is a slightly more expensive and advanced model with an Intel N4000. With the same amount of RAM, 6 GB, it has twice the internal storage, 128 GB. Regarding automatic power on after power supply, I will definitely show this moment in the video. And before we start, as usual, please like this video so that more people interested in smart home topics can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Device type, fanless mini PC. Processor type, Intel Celeron N4000, maximum frequency 2.6 GHz, RAM 6 GB, built-in internal memory, EMMC 128 GB. Additionally, M.2 slot for NVMe SSD, format 2242. Network, 1 gigabit LAN, Wi-Fi, 2.4 and 5 GHz, Bluetooth 4.2. Video, Intel HD Graphics 600, HDMI and VGA. 3 USB 3.0 and micro SD slot.
Audio output.
Size, 120 by 120 by 22 millimeters. The device is delivered in a white cubic cardboard box. From the moment of order to the moment of receipt, it took 13 days, which is quite prompt for AliExpress. You will find the link to the store in the description under the video. On one of the sides, there is a sticker indicating the model specifications, in this case, N4000, 6 GB RAM, and 128 GB EMMC. The mini PC is securely packaged, protected by a special shock-absorbing insert in addition to the box's dense cardboard walls. The package includes the mini PC itself, a power supply unit with interchangeable plugs, and a small manual. The manual is written in Chinese and English, containing nothing particularly useful or important. The power supply is rated for an input voltage of 100 to 240 volts, and comes with flat and European plugs that are easy and quick to change. The output is 12 volts, up to 24 watts. It's worth clarifying that 24 watts is the power supply's stated power, not the mini PC's actual consumption. For smart home servers, continuous operation is very important, so I recommend arranging for guaranteed power. Considering that 12 volts is a very common voltage, finding a UPS will not be a problem. For example, here is a model with smooth voltage adjustment. You can find a review of it and a link to the store in the description. It uses the same connectors, 5.5 by 2.5 millimeters as the mini PC. So the connection is very simple. The standard power supply connects to the UPS, and the UPS connects to the port on the mini PC's case. Looking ahead, according to the readings from a socket with energy monitoring, the consumption is about 4 watts, meaning with such a UPS, the mini PC will run for about 11 to 12 hours. The design is standard, almost identical to the previously reviewed Soyo M2, with minor differences such as the number of USB ports, but the size is exactly the same. On the right side, if oriented by the inscription on top, there is a slot for a micro SD card, 2 USB 3.0 ports, and a power button. On the back, there's a round power connector, a third USB also 3.0, HDMI, gigabit LAN port, and a standard audio output. On the left side, there's a VGA port, which allows the device to be used even with older monitors. On the front and top, there are no control elements, only perforations for heat dissipation. Considering that the device does not have active cooling, this is an important point. On the bottom, there is a sticker with a brief description and serial number, rubber feet at the corners, and two screw mounts in the center. Now it's time to look inside. The feet need to be removed because the screws holding the case together are underneath them. Besides screws, the cover is also held in place by clips, so you need to carefully pry it off. There's no separate compartment for SSD access like in the Soyo M2, which is not very convenient. Although the description mentioned that it uses a 2280 size disk, it clearly won't fit. A shorter variant, 2242, is needed. Unlike the Soyo, where M.2 SATA disks are needed, the hero of our review requires an NVMe disk. I didn't have one in stock, but I've already placed an order. On the back, there's a massive heatsink with no fan provided. I won't be removing it for now, as I want to observe the temperature with the factory setup. Under the top cover, two internal antennas from the Wi-Fi module are glued. It's time to power on the mini PC. First, we'll see what comes pre-installed by default. Connect the network cable to the router, keyboard, and mouse. They are only needed at the initial stage and the power supply. Initially, a splash screen with its name appears. Then, the Windows setup wizard that comes with it starts. We select the preferred language. Then your country of residence. Next, we set up the keyboard layout. If necessary, you can add a few more additionally. We agree to the license agreement. If curious, you can even read it. Now we create a user, enter a name. Create, and then repeat the password for login. In case you forget it, choose three security questions and write answers to them. I left the privacy settings as default. After that, you need to wait a few minutes while the system prepares everything for the first startup. Done. The pre-installed Windows started, but I have a different task. I plan to make this mini PC into a smart home server, so I'll only check the system information. The processor model and amount of RAM were recognized as stated in the specifications. Everything is honest here. Windows version 11 Pro is installed here, reminding that Soyo M2 had version 10. Since I haven't installed the SSD disk yet, there's only one storage, EMMC 128GB. Essentially, we are done here. Now we need to check one important thing. We reboot. To enter the BIOS, you need to press F2 during boot. The menu structure is more or less standard. The aspect I want to check is related to the PC's automatic power on feature. For this, go to the chipset menu, configuration of the South cluster. At the next step, there's only one option, so there's no particular choice but to enter it. There are two items here, both related to starting the mini PC. The first allows you to configure behavior after power is applied, which we need, and the second enables wake on LAN, but I won't cover it in this lesson. There are two options, and their description can be read on the top right. By default, S5 is enabled, in which case the mini PC needs to be turned on manually after power is applied. The second is S0, which should cause it to turn on automatically. I choose it, then save the settings and exit using the F4 key. Now, the moment of truth. I disconnect the power from the mini PC and then turn it back on. Everything works great. The mini PC starts up without pressing the button, by itself. It will behave the same way in the event of a real power outage. I remind you that for the Soyo M2, at least my version, regardless of the selected BIOS item, it had to be started manually. Next, it remains to install Home Assistant OS. I'll say right away that the process is exactly the same as for the Soyo M2 and in previously shown lessons. To deploy the system on the disk, in this case, EMMC, we need a temporary operating system, for which Linux Ubuntu is perfectly suited. The download link is in the description under the video. We also need an image of Home Assistant OS. The link can be found in the same place. Choose the version as in the screenshot. For the x86-64 platform, we will temporarily need a flash drive, onto which, using Belina Etcher, a link also in the description, we need to write the downloaded Linux Ubuntu image. While it's writing, unpack Home Assistant OS from the archive, for which I used the free Archiver 7-zip. After that, the image needs to be rewritten to another flash drive or micro SD card, which also works since the mini PC has the corresponding slot. Belina Etcher finished writing the Linux image. Disconnect the flash drive from the working computer and connect it to the mini PC. In the BIOS, which is accessed by pressing F2 during boot, we need to go to the boot section. Here, its priority is set, by default, the first is the internal storage, then the flash drive. We place it first. We need to boot into Linux Ubuntu. Done. Press F4 to save and exit the BIOS. Now the boot will be from the flash drive. We need the first option, try or install Ubuntu. Wait for this menu to load. Here, choose try Ubuntu. There's no need to install it. Wait a bit longer and see the desktop on the screen. This is a temporary operating system loaded directly from the flash drive. Now we need to connect the second flash drive or memory card with the recorded Home Assistant image. It will open automatically, or if for some reason it did not, open the File Explorer from the left panel. Here, the system image is visible. Then right-click on it and select the option, Open with Disk Image Writing Software. It's the first option. The disk selection dialog opens. Currently, there are three, the internal storage, which is displayed as SD card reader, and two flash drives, one with Ubuntu loaded, the other with the image. I select the internal storage and start the process of writing the image. The process is irreversible and will destroy all data on the drive, so the system will ask for confirmation once more. Now we wait a few minutes for the system image to be written to the storage. Done. EMMC is ready for booting, and we no longer need Linux Ubuntu. We press the power button in the upper right corner and reboot. Remove all flash drives. In BIOS, make sure that the internal storage is set as the first boot option. If everything is done correctly, it will start booting from the internal storage. There's no need to touch anything here. The booting ends approximately like this. It will show the IP address assigned by the router. Now, the monitor, keyboard, and mouse are no longer needed, and you can disconnect them. We can now work through the web interface. Go to the address shown on the screen, adding port 8123 after it with a colon. Wait for the system to start. At this stage, you can either restore from a backup, if you have one, or start installing the system from scratch. I choose the latter option. Next, we create a user, specify a name, login, create and repeat a password. Location, this step can be skipped at this stage. Country of residence, needs to be specified right away. Data analytics, I recommend enabling all options. This information will help developers improve the system. The system will display devices detected on the network, those it was able to immediately identify and connect. Each person's screen will look different. Done. The system is up and running. As you can see, it managed to connect quite a few devices. Some of them also testify to another fact. In the settings menu, select the devices and services option. Here we see a list of installed integrations. Pay attention to these two that I highlighted. Bluetooth integration, identified the built-in adapter. This integration is basic for working with Bluetooth as an interface. Other services work with the devices. Specifically, Xiaomi BLE works with gadgets from the Xiaomi ecosystem. This confirms that the built-in adapter is working correctly. For the next check, we need to go from the settings menu to the system menu. We are interested in the network tab. The system identified two adapters. This is the wired one. It's currently obtaining an address automatically. If switched to static mode, the address can be changed manually. The second, wireless, it is off by default, but scanning shows the current list of networks, both in the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz ranges. This confirms the correct operation of Wi-Fi. In the same system menu, just below, there's a storage tab. Here, in addition to the amount of occupied space for EMMC, there appears an option that shows the degree of its wear. Currently, as it should be, at a minimal level, up to 10%. When it grows to 100%, using the EMMC further is not recommended. System monitor platform sensors, which show the system load. In normal mode, the processor is loaded at 17 to 18% with peak values, which occurred during installation, not exceeding 25%. The processor temperature, reminding you that I did not remove the heatsink, left it as is from the factory, averages just under 60 degrees Celsius. RAM usage, about 10 to 11%, reminding you that 6 gigabytes is installed here. In the Soyo M2 review, I showed an aspect related to Wi-Fi performance. Activating the connection noticeably increased the processor load and its temperature. So, I decided to check this aspect here as well. This leads to an increase in processor load by 4 to 5%, and the temperature rose to almost 70 degrees Celsius. On the right side of the chart, you can see how the processor load increased. And this is the temperature chart. Therefore, the recommendation I made for Soyo M2, to use a wired connection whenever possible, is also relevant for this platform. After disconnecting, the processor load and its temperature quickly decrease, confirming the cause, it's related to the Wi-Fi module. To summarize, this is a fairly budget-friendly platform, priced slightly higher than the previously reviewed Soyo M2. However, the hero of this review features a more powerful processor and twice the amount of internal storage. Both devices support the installation of an external SSD disk, But the main advantage of this model is the correct functioning of the automatic power on mode after power restoration. This is a very important feature when used as a smart home server, making the choice obvious. However, this does not negate my recommendation to use an uninterruptible power supply. That's all. I hope you found this video useful and interesting. I'd appreciate your likes. They help promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, you'll find all the necessary links to stores where you can buy this mini PC and the mentioned UPS, to reviews and tutorial videos, as well as my Telegram channel, which is now available in 2 languages, Facebook page, and a group for smart home discussions. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to everyone.